Well, hello everybody, welcome to Shape Fixer. I am Andrew Tunstall, nutritionist and athlete, and I'm going to talk to you very briefly today about heart disease and what it actually is. Now, heart disease is a general condition leading to heart attacks and strokes. What causes the heart attack? What causes the stroke? So very briefly, the inside walls of your blood vessels can become damaged. And that's like having a scratch on your skin. And when they get damaged, they need to be repaired. So your body will patch the damage with a scab or a sticking plaster made up predominantly of white blood cells. And then other things that are floating around in your blood that shouldn't be there, particles that I'll get to, can become stuck in that scab, and the scab can become bigger than it should be. It can then crumble around the edges and bits of it break off, and then they flow through your blood vessels until they get stuck in the little capillaries somewhere and create a blockage. And if that blockage happens in the muscle of your heart, you will have a heart attack. And if that happens in the capillaries in your brain, you will have a stroke. So the problem is these injuries, these lesions on the inside walls of your blood vessels. They are leading to the problem because they need to be patched, and it's the patch that can break off and cause the heart disease. So, how do your blood vessels get damaged on the inside? Well, the answer is very simple. In 95% of cases, it is because of sugar. It is sugar. High sugar levels, consistent high sugar levels in your blood that reacts with and damages the inside wall of your blood vessel. So it would seem that the obvious answer is to maybe not have so much sugar. But I can hear you asking, what about cholesterol? How come I haven't mentioned cholesterol? So let's talk about cholesterol and what that is and what it is meant to do and where it comes from and how cholesterol gets dragged into this topic. So cholesterol is a molecule. In fact, there are two types of cholesterol. You've probably heard of LDL and HDL, okay? So never mind that for now. It is produced in your liver and has very, very important life-sustaining functions for your nervous system, your cell membranes, your brain function. You would die in about a minute if you didn't have cholesterol in your body. And like I say, the cholesterol is produced in the liver. Now, you can get some of the cholesterol from the food you eat, and if you eat food high in cholesterol, your liver will make less because it will only make what it needs to make up the difference. So you can see that cutting cholesterol out of your diet is probably not going to make any difference because your liver will just make more. Another function that cholesterol has is that the two cholesterol types, the HDL and the LDL, are like two little Uber fleets, two little fleets of taxis, and their job is to carry lipids, which are essential life-sustaining fat molecules, to carry them around in your blood between the liver and the organs where the fat is needed. And LDL will carry the blood in one direction, the fat in one direction, and HDL's job is to bring it back if it's spare or not needed and take it back to the liver. So there's these two direction flows of cholesterol molecules carrying the fat. And of course, the more fat is needed or needs to be transported, the more cholesterol your body will produce in response. So how does this affect heart disease? Well, the sugar, the high sugar that is damaging your walls of your blood vessels also damages some of the cholesterol molecules. Not the HDL. The HDL is safe from sugar, which is why it's often referred to as good cholesterol. LDL, in the presence of high sugar, can become damaged or glycated. And when some, not all, when some of the LDL molecules become damaged, they don't function properly anymore, and they become essentially a waste product floating around in your blood with no real purpose. Hence, bad cholesterol. When you have an injury in your cell, in your blood vessel wall, and that patch is laid down, Any foreign particles floating around in your blood can get stuck there. Now, one of the big culprits is particles from smoking. So don't smoke. It's not just lung cancer. It's going to give you heart disease as well, or it's going to contribute to your risk of heart disease. But another particle or foreign body that can get stuck is glycated LDL. So if you have some of your cholesterol that has been damaged because of the high sugar, those damaged LDL molecules can also get stuck in that patch. So when that patch breaks off and goes into your head and blocks the capillary and gives you a stroke, that piece of, we'll call it a scab, that caused the problem there can have smoke particles in it. It can have damaged LDL particles in it. Of course, it's got white blood vessels and other things, white blood cells, and other things in it as well. But that is where the link comes between heart disease and cholesterol. It's quite obvious that the problem is the sugar. It's the sugar that is damaging the cell, the blood vessel walls. It is the sugar that is damaging the otherwise perfectly healthy and useful cholesterol. So if you cut down the sugar and you don't do all that damage, your risk of heart disease is actually very, very low. Now, the medication that is most often prescribed to prevent heart disease is a medication that suppresses your body's ability to produce cholesterol. The thinking being that if you eat lots of sugar and you damage your artery walls and you put down these patches and you've got lots of sugar floating around in your blood, if you keep your cholesterol low, you'll have fewer cholesterol molecules being damaged by the poison of sugar. And so you'll have less cholesterol molecules in the patch that is made on the injury. And that to me just seems all back to front, because you need cholesterol. There's no point suppressing your liver's ability to produce an absolutely vital, life-sustaining molecule like cholesterol. Rather, just don't eat the sugar, and then you won't do the damage in the first place, because as we've established in Shape Fixer, you don't need sugar anyway. You absolutely don't need it. You can check some of our other videos about carbohydrates and fat and fuel sources, and there's no need for us to be eating anywhere near as much sugar as we actually do. But people somehow have been convinced that they can spend money on an expensive drug to suppress the production of a natural molecule like cholesterol, which is absolutely vital, so that they lower their risk of heart disease and then carry on eating sugar and, I guess, smoking or all those other risk factors. But the side effects of the cholesterol medications are terrible. Fatigue, muscle pain, memory loss, confusion. Why you would, and that is because you are low in cholesterol. So cholesterol isn't the big scary monster we've been made to believe. You need to manage your sugar intake and that way lower your risk of heart disease. There's a reason obesity is listed as the number one risk factor, because obesity is also linked to overconsumption of sugar and carbohydrates. So I hope that makes it a little clearer. If you're getting a blood test and your doctor says your cholesterol is high, you need to have a serious conversation with your doctor to make sure that A, your doctor knows what he's talking about, what cholesterol. And it doesn't help just going, oh, but we've divided it up between HDL and LDL and your LDL level is too high. What about the damaged LDL? How much of that LDL is actually damaged? And that's a further test, and that is not normally shown in a basic cholesterol test. So the basic cholesterol test, other than telling you that your triglyceride level might be too high, and that is a special type of fat that is formed from sugar when you have too much sugar, and it's on its way to becoming body fat. So that will give you some idea, but the actual cholesterol numbers themselves are relatively meaningless. Anyway, there it is, heart disease. It's caused by sugar. So let us know what you think. Share your comments below. share this video if you think it'll help someone else. Click like if it helped you. And remember to subscribe to the Shape Fixer channel so you don't miss any of our new content.